Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another episode of Raynday Gaming. My name is Raynday, and today we're taking a look at how to play Smite, featuring Sun Wukong. But it's going to be a little bit different. A lot of you are used to me covering all the how-to-play details, such as gameplay tactics, tips and tricks, builds, abilities, etc. during a gameplay. Although it's pre-recorded and I speak after it, sometimes it can be a little haphazard and I can get caught and focused on some of the commentary rather than the information. So, instead of dropping that completely, what I thought I'd do is add an ability section to the front. This is where we'll discuss the abilities, what they do, the types of damage they have, and of course, how to use them and what specific scenarios you can expect to find them most valuable. And after that, we'll go into the gameplay. This is where we'll discuss the build and general tips and tricks. Now, of course, if you're very interested in seeing a gameplay of Sun Wukong on my channel, then you can go ahead and skip right to the gameplay. That way, this series has something for everybody. How to Play is a series that's geared towards beginners, and this should help beginners get that concrete information in a better format. I always want to make my videos as conducive to learning as possible and helping every single person who watches them find value. Take a moment at the end of this video to add some feedback as to what you thought about the new format, and of course, just to let you know, when I get into my new apartment, I'll also be coming on screen at the beginning of each of these episodes to introduce what we're talking about and also to close out the series. It could be very similar to a Know Your Enemy style intro and exit, and I hope you all will enjoy that soon. So, without further ado, let's get started. So, before we go into Sun Wukong's abilities, you should know, if you don't know already, that he's a Chinese warrior. We talked about this, but warriors have a lot of characteristics that are very important to them, and understanding that defense and cooldown and the ability to affect the backline are very important for warriors to succeed, and Sun Wukong has a lot of tools in his kit to be able to fulfill that role. Taking a look at Sun Wukong's passive, it's called Undefeated Body. When Sun Wukong is below 35% health, he gains 10% critical chance and 10 protections, plus another 1% critical chance and 1 protection for his current level. And so what that means is at max level, level 20, Sun Wukong gains 30% critical chance and 30 protections while under his passive's threshold of 35% health, which means he's also getting 30 magical protections and 30 physical protections. That's what that means when it is written that way. And so Sun Wukong is a very dangerous character to fight at low health. Many people play gods, and when they get to that low threshold, think, oh no, I must retreat, but Sun Wukong's kit is actually intended to allow him to fight at that low threshold and gain these distinct advantages over the people he's fighting. Now, on to Sun Wukong's first ability called the Magic Cudgel. Sun Wukong's Magic Cudgel grows in length, and he slams it down, damaging all enemies in front of him. Minions and jungle camps take an extra 25% damage, which is something I think a lot of people overlook. Look, I'm gonna be really honest, I did not realize that about this god until like this week. At max rank, this ability does 240 damage and takes 50% of your physical power. But there are a couple of things to note about it that are very useful. While Sun Wukong winds this ability up, he can move and turn to change the area of effect, which means you could be running away from someone, use your number one, and while it is slamming down onto the ground, turn around and hit them at that last moment. It's kind of like doing a 180 whenever Medusa ults you so you don't get stunned. He can do that essentially and hit you while almost maintaining a perfect running speed. It's very damaging, very surprising, and if you don't expect it, can really ruin your day. And with the increased 25% damage to minions and jungle camps, this ability will do 300 total plus 62% of your physical power. In most scenarios, this is what I would suggest leveling up on Sun Wukong first and also using as your primary wave clear. Sun Wukong's second ability is called Master's Will. Sun Wukong strikes around him, damaging and slowing all enemies. Now, this ability got a little worse. It used to knock up and made Sun Wukong really freaking hard to deal with. Currently, it does 90 damage and scales all the way up at max rank to 290 damage, a little bit more than Magic Cudgel, and it also takes that 50% of his physical power. The other interesting thing to note about it is that it slows for 30% for 2 seconds, which is quite a decent slow and can help you to get a couple more basic attacks or guarantee the damage from your Magic Cudgel for those opponents who seem to be dodging it quite effectively. Moving on to Sun Wukong's third ability, it's called 72 Transformations. Sun Wukong transforms into an eagle, a tiger, or an ox and charges forward, and each of these forms do something completely different. Now, the eagle is your main form of escape or catching up to somebody if they're very far away. It's the fastest of the three forms by far, and you're immune to slow and root effects, so if Neith were to turn around, try to spirit arrow you, you, she wouldn't do anything. It would just kind of do the damage and it wouldn't root you at all. Wouldn't even slow you. Not that it slows. Anyways, the Tiger form is something that is very single target oriented. So this will be your main initiation onto a single target. It does the most damage by far at maxing out at 380 at level 5, taking 80% of your physical power. And so this will be a great way if you see a target that you want to ambush in the jungle, or you want to come from the jungle and ambush a target in lane and just hit them specifically. Maybe they're a high damage carry. This will be the choice of yours. It's in the middle section and is sometimes a little bit hard to hit. Know, however, that as you level up the ability, you'll gain increased time onto the stun. So it'll go from 1 to 1.4 seconds at max level 5. And the cooldown of all of these forms and this entire ability as you level it up will actually go from 18 to 14. So one of those abilities that actually decreases in cooldown as you level it up. That's one of the benefits. The last form is the Ox form. And this is a form I see a lot of people use incorrectly. This form is all about causing havoc and getting out of a tight situation or disrupting a lot of enemies at once. This is not your best wave clear, of course. If you want a wave clear, you need to use your number one. But the Ox is very good at, again, disrupting patterns going on. Maybe somebody's in a fight, maybe two characters feel confident and you've got teammates rolling in, knocking them up with Ox form, getting a slow onto them, hitting your number one can totally disrupt the rhythm of the fight and put them on their heels. It also is immune to slow, root, and knockup effects. So if you want to stay immune during a Sylvanas ult, or some moment the Geb is trying to knock you up, you will actually be able to pop into your Ox form and not get knocked up or CC'd during that time. I often see people try to use this form as a way to escape, and it can be, but if you've just got open space in front of you, use your Eagle form. If you've got several enemies in front of you, however, Ox form is a great choice. You'll knock them up, you'll go through them, and you'll likely buy yourself enough time to get to safety. However, do realize that you have a slower turn rate while you're transformed, so you're not going to be doing these 360 no scope stuns while you're in Tiger form. You're going to be turning very slowly, so make sure you get the angle correctly and know that it will stop on a minion if it hits it. Last but certainly not least is Somersault Cloud, Sun Wukong's ultimate. Sun Wukong leaps into his cloud, leaving a decoy behind to fight. While on the cloud, Sun Wukong is invisible and regenerates health. He may leap off before the duration expires, dealing damage, or if the duration expires, he'll leap off anyway. The decoy inherits a percentage of Sun Wukong's current strength and defense. The decoy is killed instantly if hit by a hard crowd control, excluding banishes and knockbacks. If the decoy dies, Sun Wukong is revealed on his cloud. So, that's a lot to take in. Let's talk about the basics. It does 340 damage when you crash down, plus 120% of your physical power, which is extremely strong scaling, so this ability will hurt. You also heal, remember that, in the cloud for a percentage of your health? That's 5% of your health per second. Remember, you could stay up in your cloud for 5 seconds, so you can essentially gain 25% of your health back. Now, the cooldown on this ability decreases as well as you level it up from 110 to 90 seconds, and there are a few more tips and notes about how it works. So, it's good to note that Sun Wukong is immune to crowd control for the duration of this ultimate. Obviously, he's going to be in a cloud, so it's hard to shoot a cloud in Smite, but even when he begins channeling his ultimate, he cannot be CC'd, so he is basically unkillable. Well, actually, that's a lie. He is killable. He can still take damage while channeling his ultimate and going up into the air, but once he's in the air, you cannot touch him until he comes down. The thing is, he can't be CC'd during that 1 second channel time either, so unless you can burst him down very, very quickly, he's gonna get his health back and he's gonna be back in the fight. The other good thing to note is that the decoy he creates is considered a god by enemy towers, who will continue to target it until it expires, regardless of if you or an ally deal damage to an enemy god inside its attack range, meaning your decoy can serve as somebody just tanking a tower for you while you go in and try and finish off a low health target, which is really, really good to know. Now you know what his abilities do, let's move into the gameplay and talk about builds, tips, tricks, and strategies for how to play Sun Wukong to his best potential. My name is Raynday, and I'm excited to be talking about a Sun Wukong build now that I've been using for quite a while, and just my general playstyle with this god. He's a very bully-type god, in my opinion, and in lane, you want to harass people as much as possible with your magic cudgel. That's one of my biggest tips and tricks, is to be aggressive with Sun Wukong, knowing that you can escape and get out of troublesome situations pretty easily as this character. He's very tanky, and that tankiness can help to increase his ability to effectively last longer in a fight, and thus do more damage. A lot of people feel they need to build damage in order to do damage, but if you're in the fight and you're hitting your basic attacks and you just can't be killed, you're gonna get the kills. And that's what happened for our team here as we took down the Jibalanque on the side of the enemy team. Now, I'm starting with Bluestone and level 2 boots, which is one of the combinations I like on some Wukong. I'm going into my Tiger form to stun him and increase the damage and increase the time he is CC'd so we can get off more basic attacks, more fire, and more chains on a stationary target. I also finish him off with my Magic Cudgel for the kill, which means I'm doing that consistent damage to him and fighting very comfortably in my low health threshold. Remember, some Wukong's passive is called Undefeated Body, and that's when I gain my 30% extra critical chance, and I also gain my 30% protections on each side, which is quite a lot, and that allows you to start in a Bluestone boots fashion and still in those close end fights have the protection advantage over your opponents. Now I'm backing off into lane because of course I'm healing up my health and I've got my ultimate available. Part of the great understanding of Sun Wukong is knowing when to be super aggressive and knowing when not to. When your ultimate is available, you can pretty much do anything and not die. Now, I know this is going to be hard for you if you're a newer player, but trust me, as you play with caution, you see the stun going into the Ares there. The Jabalanki has got me low. My Undefeated Body passive is up. You could see that in the fire on the left-hand side being ignited. I'm going into my ult, and suddenly it's down because I've started gaining my health back, and I've gotten that 25% of my health back into my life pool. As the Ares misses his chains and Jabalanki hits a basic attack, I decide to aggress with my Tiger form, but I miss. Remember, the turning rate is very, very slow, and now our Ares is in trouble. What should we do? Fight. Fight, fight, fight. I've got Undefeated Body, I've got crits, and now I'm going after the Sun Wukong with my Magic Cudgel, which I can hit him, the Jabalanki with my Magic Cudgel, which I can hit him very safely from range. I'm trying to finish off the archers because I know I have lane pressure, and my partner is going in. He misses his chains, and now he's in trouble. He pops his own frenzy, and I go over to help him out because two is stronger than one. Again, the aggressiveness and the Undefeated Body passive allows me to crit two times onto the Jabalanki, and with the extra protections that he didn't have, meaning I have 56 and 53 protections now for magical and physical damage allow me to stay alive, and those extra crits allowed me to actually go ahead and get the kill. This is where Undefeated Body becomes very important to understand and when you should be taking fights and when you shouldn't. Of course, every 2v1 advantage is going to be very strong for you. So if you have characters or you have a situation where it's just 1v2, a lot of scenarios, people will get low and one of them, because they're not friends or they don't care about each other, will just run around and try to save their own hide. But if you fight together, there's a big chance that you'll be able to get that kill over that one person, even if you both are terribly low, because you can't hit two people at the same time. And of course, two people can hit one person at the same time. Now, of course, we're going back into lane, and I've decided to pick up Breastplate of Valor. Breastplate of Valor is a great pickup for me on Sun Wukong because it allows him to get his cooldown and his protections. This is a very, very important quality, and as my Bluestone ticks down onto the Jabalanki after the Magic Cudgel damage, you'll see that he is now dead by Deathwalker himself, one of my friends from my clan. Like I said, Breastplate of Valor is, again, one of the key staple items that I like to build on my warriors. It allows me to have the physical protection, but also the cooldown percentage, which I find very, very important. Now, I hit the Ares, which is bad of me, and so I get the target pressure from the tower, but I pop into my ultimate and regain 25% of my health, so then I could stay pressuring. I've been targeted by a tower just there, but now I'm still in lane, and I don't have to go back and retreat for, you know, my life, because now I've gotten into my ultimate. A lot of times, you can use your ultimate just to regain that 25% of your health, and then put yourself in a position to stay in lane, continue the fight, or just be helpful to a teammate who may want some pressure. Even though you're not going to be aggressive, they just want you to stay in lane for the time being while they're doing something, grabbing a buff, etc., etc. So the Ares is pretty low on mana, and I notice he's going to have to back pretty soon as well, and I decide to back and pick up the third tier of my Breastplate of Valor, and then I start to make a decision. This is where, as a Sun Wukong, you want to make a decision, and I think a lot of people get caught up in making the wrong decision. Right now, you want to choose. You want to understand the game. Are you ahead or are you behind? After you finish Breastplate of Valor, you need to make the decision if you want damage and you want cooldown, you want some pen, or if you want more protection and more health. Are you more of the standard tank for your team, or are you somebody who's going to be relied on to get some kills? And in this game, I've noticed that my damage is very impactful, it's very meaningful, and so I will be looking to go for a penetration cooldown route to add to the cooldown I have onto Breastplate of Valor. Now, there's a couple of cool items that can do this, but my favorite is Jotunn's Wrath. The reason being is I get the flat penetration, which is always good for ability-based gods like warriors, who have their abilities able to hit with a little bit more gusto, so to speak, and penetrate the god's protections a lot better. And of course, when you're doing abilities like you know, with power-oriented abilities, you're going to want items like this, like Jotunn's Wrath, to give you a pretty decent amount of power and allow you to increase, of course, the percentage that you're getting scaled onto your base damage for your attack. So I think Magic Cudgel does 240 damage, and you know, adding on to the 50% of your physical power, it's at 55 right now, but as I pick up another, you know, 40 plus item, that's going to be around 100, and I'm going to be taking, you know, an extra 20 power now onto my abilities as a result of that. Transcendence is an item you could pick up on some ability power type, you know, characters like this, but it's not necessary. As you see immediately, the ultimate countering the Ares, and I'm landing down, getting the kill onto him. One of the best things to note is how I use the Ox form here, just to disrupt and to put the Nox in a bad spot. I'm fighting the Jibalanque, I'm going after him, I hit him with one crit, and I hit him with the second one, and that takes him down. The Magic Cudgel from range takes down onto the Nox, and the chains take her down from the Ares, and that is just a very perfect team fight from a Sun Wukong and group. The Magic Cudgel, doing the damage onto the Nox from far, the undefeated body passive allowing me the two crits on the Djibalanque, and of course going into my ultimate to counter the Ares ultimate. A lot of people don't realize, of course, but you are CC immune, which we talked about in the ability section. But that means that anybody who has a CC-oriented kit or ability, you can get out of that by simply preempting it and using your ultimate. Now, there's that channel time where you can still take damage in the beginning, even though you're not CC immune. So if you're about to die and you use it at the very last second, Ares will kill you because Ares' ult does damage. This is very important to note. You can't just use that portion of the early part of your ultimate at any time. If you use it too late, the damage from the ability will still take effect and you will die before you can get into your cloud. But if you use it early on and you get into your cloud, you should be good with being able to survive most anything people can throw at you and either escape or continue to re-engage. Like I said, I'm going for Jotunn's Wrath here, which is a good item for me because I feel now when I'm 5-0-3, I have the ability to attack and be effective in damage now and scale off of the fact that I've already had a lot of success. I am level 14 and they're all level 10. A level 11 is their max. So again, this damage I feel is safe because I've got the base protections from having more levels and I have the advantage in health and pretty much items as well. So I feel very, very safe about going into this. But if you didn't, you might want to pick up some defensive items. Some of the defensive items I really like on Sun Wukong are Bulwark of Hope, which in this game I'll probably transition to after Jotunn's Wrath. That's the kind of path I like to take. As you see, using the Tiger to initiate on a single target like the Ravan, and now he's in trouble and he's killed immediately. That is how you want to use the Tiger from the jungle, just to initiate single target onto somebody that's not expecting it. We get another basic attack to get the kill, and now a single target onto the Nox is going to allow me to hit two basic attacks. The slow isn't there. The Magic Cudgel misses, however, and that's a little unfortunate. I wanted to chase after her, so I pop my sprint and my eagle form, the Magic Cudgel to try and get the damage to finish off, but the tick over time from Bluestone doesn't do it. And of course, if I had hit my Magic Cudgel earlier on, I think I probably would have done enough damage to, after I caught up with her again, to kill her. But you know what? That just didn't take place. And of course, it's very important to understand the rhythm of how to use that ability. It's something that is very important. Sun Wukong, again, just being a very big bully, when you get him a lead in lane and use his advantages of having the extra protections and being a little tankier early on, you will be able to then pretty much do whatever you want in a game. It will be very hard for people to burst you down, and when they get close to killing you, you can pop in your ultimate. After that, your cooldowns are still going off, and thus that means you could then pop out of your ultimate after 5 seconds and use your ability to fly away, as you see me there, using the eagle form to get out of tight situations. No one's in front of me, so eagle form. That's the fastest amount of speed. I can't be slowed or rooted, and so therefore, I use the eagle form again, like I said, to get out of tough situations when no one is in front of me. If characters are there, however, I might want to use the ox form, but now I want to go damage onto the Ares. I feel very confident. His chains and fire are down, so I know that he doesn't have that available. I use my number two to actually go ahead and stop the Ravan, and I end up getting the kill, and now Ares is coming in. I pop the ultimate, but as you notice, I took a little bit of his damage there. I'm ready to use and jump down onto both of them. I use the stun because I try to actually stun the both of them in Nox ultimate, and I actually get taken down right there. Princess Pawn takes me down. What I might want to do, which is a good correction for myself, is pop into the Ox form, knock them both up rather than going for the stun, and allow her to have that second or second and a half delay where she can't use her ability. She's knocked up, she's CC'd, because the stun damage and the silence is what really threw me off and took me down. It wasn't a stun, it was a silence, and a root. So again, you cannot be rooted in your ox form, but you can be silenced, and that will put it in a bad situation. So just remember that when playing against an ox. A couple of other items that you can pick up on Sun Wukong, which are very nice, are Mantle of Discord. Hide of the Urchin as well is a pretty good item for warriors, as it is a pretty much give you the most protections you will ever be able to have in a game. And of course, other items that I like to suggest are items like Frostbound Hammer. Items that allow Sun Wukong to have some health, have some power, but also have more effectiveness when sticking to the backline targets. It's very easy for him to get to a target. He can ox form, he can eagle form, he can tiger form to them. He can go into his ult and jump down into the back line. But when he gets there, how can he stay with them? He's got the slow from Master's Will, but he's also, if he gets an item like Frostbound, has the ability to slow them and keep them there, especially if he starts fighting with his undefeated body passive up. It's going to allow him to slow them and potentially crit over and over again and keep them in the range of basic attack so he can access the crits going on. All right, everybody, so that's going to do it for me today and the rest of this video. It's going to be up to you now to take Sun Wukong out onto the battlefield and do the best that you can. Hopefully you enjoyed this new kind of setup for how to play. If you did enjoy it, please leave your feedback in the comment section below. Even if you didn't enjoy it, I'd love to hear your feedback as well and what we can do to keep improving the series on the channel for you. As always, leave a like, share, comment, and subscribe to stay tuned for more content like this here on my channel. And as always, remember to never give up, never stop gaming, and I'll see you all next time.